Everyone, this is Edionic. Today we are going to take a look at yet another analysis technique called the Supermesh Analysis. Actually, the Supermesh Analysis is just a modification of the conventional mesh analysis. So, it is only required to modify the already existing mesh analysis that you know to incorporate is small difference in the circuit provided. So I just have to mention or point out a thing that is something that I forgot to mention in my previous video on mesh analysis, which is this. If we have a circuit, simple circuit like this, we normally consider two meshes, one right here, the other one right here. Actually, we have a third mesh which can also be considered like this. So we can consider any two combinations of meshes to find two equations and thus two currents I1 and I2. So this is the only thing you have to know before going to mesh analysis. So let's now understand the supermesh analysis by the help of a problem. I am just drawing a simple circuit that this is a current source and its direction is towards left. Okay, so this is a 50 volt battery, 10 ohm, 5 ohms and 2 ohm, 1 ohm. This is a 2 ampere current source, and here we have a resistor which is 3 ohm. So this is our circuit, and we have to find out the current through 5 ohm. So first we have to proceed as in mesh analysis. So step 1 is assign loop currents. Now we assign the polarities. This is optional because if you have practiced a lot, you will directly write the equation. And in case I'm just writing plus minus plus minus. Here this is common for two loops, so we don't write. If we have any doubt, you can refer my previous video on mesh analysis. So next we write the equations. For the first loop, this is a normal loop, so we can write the equation as 10 into I1 minus I2 plus 5 into I1 minus I3 minus 50, as I encountered the negative sign first. So here I1 is given more importance because we consider loop 1, so I1 minus the other current. This is the first mesh equation. Now to write the second mesh equation, we normally consider the second loop right here, but note that this is a 2 ampere current source. We don't know how to find out the voltage drop across a current source, so what we do is we just avoid it. So we consider a super mesh right here. So on applying mesh equation of this bigger loop, we get 2 into I2, which is a voltage of across 2 ohm, plus 1 into I3 plus 5 into I3 minus I1 plus 10 into I2 minus I1 equal to 0. So this is the second loop equation. So we got two equations in three variables. Now we need one more to find out their values. So we consider the branch that we avoided in order to take the supermesh. That is this branch here. I'm writing it over here. This is a 2 ampere current source, and we have I2 in its direction and I3 in this direction. So I2 has dominance as the net current is in I2's direction. So we write the equation as I2 minus I3 is equal to 2 ampere. Thus we get three equations in three variables, and everything that we have to do is done. Now we have to just solve for I1, I2, I3. On solving the equations, we get the values as I1 equal to 19.99 amperes, I2 equal to 17.33 amperes, and I3 equal to 15.33 amperes. So now our question is to find the current through 5 ohm here, the 5 ohm, and we have 5 ohm, and the current I1 is in this direction and I3 is in this direction. So I1 is greater than I3, so we get a net current downwards in the direction of I1 equal to 19.99 minus 15.33 is equal to 4.66 amperes. So this is how we solve this problem with super mesh analysis. I hope you understand this method. I actually want to say that this is a very simple technique if we have mastered the mesh analysis technique. So if you like this video and if you want more videos on more subject, please subscribe my channel and put the recommendations and doubts in the comment section below. Thank you.